Europe's aluminium industry is heavily impacted by Chinese overcapacity. And not only by overcapacity, but subsidized overcapacity. China has increased its capacity in the last 15 years from just 10% to 57%. And not only this, whilst the economy slowed down in the last year, China continued to build new capacity year after year. So in the meantime, they not only dominate the global capacity, but only their excess capacity is five times as big as a European production, real production. And knowing that aluminium is a global price taker at the metal exchange in London, that means prices are immediately depressed, and they are depressed especially for those who are producing in Europe with much higher fair prices on energy. In the very same 15 years, Europe has, despite growing demand, global growing demand for aluminium, lost one third of its primary capacity. Why is it? Because we have a completely different level of regulation in Europe. Energy costs are much higher. Environmental issues play a much bigger role. So there is no level playing field anymore. We have done a lot in the last years. We better understand the threat, but it's not enough. We have to do more. And in that context, we can clearly thank the Parliament for taking actions in the last years. We also see better trade defense tools coming introduced. However, now we also need to see them really applicated. We have to use the tools we have. Just a few months ago, the OECD has published a report about the global aluminium industry and the market distortions through state subsidies. And we talk about $70 billion in total in the period of 2013 and 2016. And 85% of these $70 million can be just attributed to five Chinese companies. These are the root cause of the situation we have to get over.